So hi guys, I hope you all are doing good. And since we could not have a live session due to tech issues today, we are putting up this recorded session. If any one of you has any doubt, you can mention in the comments and we'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. Right, so let's not waste any time and begin with the session. Okay. And before moving to question number one, I would like to ask you guys to subscribe to our channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon which is flashing on the screen. It can help you to stay in touch with us and get all the notifications regarding different news updates, right? So here is your question number one for today, and it says, according to a notification, RBI has recently decided to replace the words venture capital fund companies with dash. Right, so there is a new notification by RBI recently in July which says that the name venture capital fund companies has to be removed and there is something new which has to be put up in place of it. Right, and the correct option for this question is solution D, option D. Option D is the correct solution, which says alternative investment fund companies. So guys, what are alternative investment fund companies? AIF refers to the investment which does not take place in traditional investment avenues, right? So usually what we do is, when we want to invest money, we put up our money into traditional investment avenues like stocks and bonds. But AIF refers to alternative investment fund. That means not putting your money into traditional investment avenues, but in some new investment avenues like private equity, hedge funds, so these are some alternate investment avenues. So basically putting your money into these type of funds which then invest the money into other companies. So not putting the money directly into these traditional investment avenues, but in some alternate avenues, right? So this is the correct option. Now let's see what RBI has notified. So it has said that companies that are registered under section 12 of SEBI Act 1992 and are non-deposit accepting, that is they do not take any deposits from people, are provided an exemptions from the provisions of 45 IA and 45 IC of RBI Act 1934. So don't get confused here. So yahan kya kaha ja raha hai ki jitni bhi venture capital fund companies hain jo ki SEBI ke law के अंडर रजिस्टर्ड हैं, सेबी में सेक्शन 12 के अंडर रजिस्टर्ड हैं, पर वो कोई भी डिपॉजिट नहीं लेती हैं पब्लिक से. कोई भी, जिस तरीके से आप बैंक में डिपॉजिट कराते हो उस तरीके से वो कोई भी डिपॉजिट पब्लिक से एक्सेप्ट नहीं करती है जैसे कि बैंक्स करते हैं. सो उस केस में उन वेंचर कैपिटल फंड कंपनीज को अब दो प्रोविजन से एग्जेम्प्ट कर दिया गया है. मतलब उनको ये दो लॉज फॉलो नहीं करने पड़ेंगे. कौन से दो लॉज हैं? सेक्शन 45 IA और सेक्शन 45 IC. सो गाइज, डू रिमेंबर सेक्शन 12 जो है वो रजिस्ट्रेशन की बात कर रहा है कि जो रजिस्टर्ड हैं सेबी के अंडर, और सेक्शन 45 के ये जो दो पार्ट्स हैं ये बता रहे हैं कि ये दो लॉज अब एप्लीकेबल नहीं होंगे इन वेंचर फंड, वेंचर कैपिटल फंड कंपनीज पर, राइट? सो एज आई टोल्ड यू, सेक्शन 12 इट रिलेट्स टू रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ वेरियस प्लेयर्स इन फाइनेंशियल मार्केट्स. So guys, what I said was that all the companies which are registered under SEBI as VCF or Venture Capital Fund, now they won't have to follow two laws. So this is the law which says about registration, Section 12 of SEBI Act, and now they will be exempted, or they won't have to follow two laws of RBI Act. So do you see the difference? This is Section 12 of SEBI Act, and here we are talking about two laws of RBI Act. So they won't have to follow these laws by RBI, right? And what are these laws? First of all, Section 45 IA of RBI Act relates to registration of NBFCs. मतलब अब इन कंपनीज को NBFCs की तरह, NBFCs के नाम के अंडर, उस कैटेगरी के अंडर रजिस्टर नहीं करना होगा जो इनको पहले करना पड़ता था. सो इसलिए द लॉज विच आर एप्लीकेबल टू NBFCs वुड नॉट बी एप्लीकेबल टू दीज वेंचर कैपिटल फंड companies because now they don't have to register as NBFC. इसलिए NBFC पर लागू होने वाले सारे rules इन पर apply नहीं होंगे. After that, section 45IC, it refers to a law which says creation of reserve fund by NBFCs. So, इस section के अंदर ये बताया गया था कि NBFCs को एक रिजर्व फंड क्रिएट करना पड़ता है. नाउ सिंस ये जो VCF कंपनीज हैं इनको NBFCs के अंदर ही रजिस्टर नहीं करना है, सो ऑब्वियसली दे डोंट हैव टू क्रिएट दिस रिजर्व फंड ऑल्सो, राइट? क्योंकि इनको NBFCs, सिंस दे डू नॉट हैव टू रजिस्टर एज NBFCs नाउ, दे डू नॉट हैव टू फॉलो एनी लॉ दैट रिलेट्स टू NBFC और दे डू नॉट हैव टू फॉलो द क्रिएशन ऑफ रिजर्व फंड लॉ बाय NBFC, राइट? एंड this change has been undertaken because SEBI repealed the SEBI venture capital fund regulation 1996. so SEBI ka ek law tha jisme wo venture capital fund companies ki baat karte the aur unko kaise regulate karna hai uske bare mein baat karte the, wo SEBI ne repeal kiya ya fir wapas le liya aur isi wajah se RBI ne bhi ab change kiya hai aur wo keh rahe hain ki hum venture capital fund company ki jagah use karenge the term alternative investment fund companies, right? So now I hope you get that the reason behind this is that SEBI repealed its law or SEBI took back the law which related to regulation of VCF companies. That is why RBI also said that to be uniform with SEBI to follow the same rules as SEBI, we are not going to call these venture capital fund companies as venture capital fund but as alternative investment fund, which we talked about here, right? I hope आपको AIF का मतलब भी समझ में आ गया हो, जिसका मतलब होता है traditional investment avenues जो पहले से चलते आ रहे हैं जैसे कि stocks और bonds, उनमें invest ना करके कुछ modern investment avenues जैसे कि किसी private equity, hedge fund या इस तरीके के नए investments में invest करना, जो directly companies में invest नहीं करते but पैसा pool कर रहे हैं और फिर invest कर रहे हैं. So AIFs can be considered as a little riskier, right? Okay, moving ahead. So here is your second question for today, which says select the correct statement or statements. So there are some statements given to you about RBI and the outbreak of coronavirus, and you have to select the correct statements out of these options. So now you can pause the video and have a look at these options and then select your answer, right? So I will be moving on to the correct option, and the correct option is solution B. Option B is the correct answer, which means 1 and 3 are the correct options, 1 and 3, and rest are the incorrect statements. Now let us examine these statements. What do these statements say? Okay, the first one is saying that RBI wanted to bring the lending rates down since January 2019. So the outbreak of coronavirus, it happened around February 2020 in India, right? So, but RBI wanted to spark growth in the economy. Indian economy was already in a slow phase. Indian economy pehle se hi bahut acha nahi kar rahi thi corona se pehle. Pehle bhi hamari growth jo thi wo slow ho rahi thi. Aur 2019 se hi RBI worried tha, RBI ko chinta thi ki hame जो है इकोनॉमी को बूस्ट करना है या फिर इसको तेजी से ग्रो कराना है, और उसके लिए आरबीआई क्या कर सकता है? सो फॉर एन इकोनॉमी टू ग्रो एट अ फास्टर रेट, इट्स सेंट्रल बैंक कैन ब्रिंग द रेट्स डाउन, द लेंडिंग रेट्स एट विच लोन्स आर अवेलेबल टू पब्लिक, दे कैन ब्रिंग दोज रेट्स डाउन, एंड इफ दे सक्सीड इन दैट पीपल टेक मोर लोन्स एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट मनी दे कंज्यूम मोर, राइट? सो लोन लेना जितना सस्ता होगा आप उतने ज़्यादा लोन लोगे और उतना ही ज़्यादा कंज्यूम करोगे. सो इस थॉट के साथ आरबीआई ने सोचा था कि हम लेंडिंग रेट्स जो हैं वो कम कर देंगे, बट आरबीआई वाज नॉट वेरी सक्सेसफुल इन डूइंग सो. सो इट हैड सम शेयर ऑफ सक्सेस बट नॉट एट द स्पीड एट विच इट थॉट, राइट? सो आरबीआई को थोड़ी बहुत सक्सेस मिली इसमें, बट उतनी तेज़ी से वो रेट्स को नहीं गिरा पाए जितनी तेज़ी से वो चाहते थे. और ऐसा क्यों हुआ वो हम अभी डिस्कस करते हैं. But after the outbreak of coronavirus, it has made lending rates fall rapidly. So after the outbreak of corona, that is after February 2020, in India the lending rates fell rapidly. They came down with a lot of speed. So what RBI wanted to do, coronavirus helped it to bring down the lending rates and why it happened, how corona was helpful, we are going to discuss it, right? Okay. So as I told you, wanted to bring down the interest rates to stimulate the economy so that this cycle kicks in. Here you can see the cycle. I hope most of us are aware of this. When repo rates or the policy rates come down, the lending becomes cheaper, the borrowing becomes cheaper for banks. जब इंटरेस्ट रेट गिरते हैं तो बैंक्स को कम इंटरेस्ट रेट पे लोन मिल पाता है आरबीआई से, और अगर उनको चीप लोन मिल रहे हैं तो ऑब्वियसली बात है कि वो आगे भी चीपर लोन्स प्रोवाइड करना चाहेंगे, राइट? सो बैंक्स प्रोवाइड चीपर लोन्स टू देयर बोरोअर्स एज वेल. बोरोअर्स टेक मोर लोन्स, कंज्यूम मोर, एंड कंजम्पशन बूस्ट इकोनॉमी, राइट? सो आई होप दिस साइकिल इज क्लियर टू यू. वेरी सिंपल. आई थिंक वी हैव बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट इट अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स इन आवर सेशंस. But now what was happening, what was actually happening, why RBI was not very successful in bringing down the interest rate? Because here the banks were not passing on the interest rates. So as former governor of RBI Raghuram Rajan mentioned that if we consider two tankers, right, one let's say is RBI and one let's say is the economy. I think I have told you this analogy before also in some video, and these two are connected by a pipe. So RBI, if it wants to bring any change in an economy, or if we want to transfer something from tanker 1 to tanker 2, we'll have to use a pipe. Similarly, RBI uses a pipe, they are known as banks. So if RBI wants to bring any change in economy, they do it through banks. But if there is a leakage in this pipe, the water is going to come out and not reach in sufficient amounts to tanker 2. Same is the case here. If banks do not do their job properly, do not transmit the rates, agar wo pass on nahi karenge tanker 1 se tanker 2 tak rates ko, to fir kya hoga? Usse RBI jo karna cha raha hai wo properly nahi hoga, right? I hope now you are clear. But banks aisa kyun kar rahe the? Why were banks not passing on the interest rates? So this was because the banks thought, okay, we are getting loans at cheaper rates from RBI, but if we reduce our lending rates as well as the deposit rates, so guys do understand that the deposit rates, there is difference between lending rate and the interest rate on deposit. So the lending rate is the rate at which banks lend to their borrowers. So if you want to take a home loan, you go to bank, the interest rate that it charges you is the lending rate, whereas the interest on deposit should be interest on deposit, it refers to the interest rate that banks provide to its depositors. So if you go to a bank and open an account, and there you keep your money, the interest rate that banks give to you, because now you are giving money to bank, so bank has to give you an interest, the interest rate that it gives you is known as interest on deposits, right? So these are two types of rates. So when policy rates come down, the repo rate by RBI come down, the lending rate and the deposit rate, both of them fall, right? And why do they fall? Because now banks are getting funding at cheaper rate because from RBI, and now they can afford to lend cheaper as well as they can afford to provide cheaper interest rate to their depositors who are providing them a cheaper, who are providing them with funds. They want that depositors should take out their money and invest them into riskier assets to boost the economy, right? So so this is how transmission takes place. And now what was happening? Policy rates were coming down, but banks were not reducing the interest rates because they thought if we reduce the interest rates, our depositors are going to withdraw the money and put them somewhere else. So if you have an account at, let's say, SBI, and SBI reduces the interest that it gives you, now you think that let me take my money out and put it into stocks because I'm not getting much return, right? So banks had a fear of withdrawal of deposits, and deposits are a major source of fund for banks, right? So this fear didn't allow banks to reduce their lending rate, as you can see here, because they feared that if they cut their interest rates, their deposits. Depositors might withdraw their deposits from banks and invest them into other investments providing better returns. But now what is happening is the sentiment is very low. The investor sentiment in market is very low. That is why even if people are getting low interest on deposits, a major chunk of the society, not all of them, but a major chunk of the society, especially the middle class, they are thinking that it's okay if I'm getting low returns, if I'm getting low interest, I'll keep my money at the bank because it is safe there. Right. So currently, less people have appetite for risk, less people have risk-taking abilities. That is why they are not withdrawing their money to invest them into riskier assets. Right. Especially the middle class section. So that is why now the fear of banks has gone. They don't worry that the depositors are going to withdraw their rates. Withdraw their deposits. That is why now they can afford to cut the lending rates. So do you see how coronavirus, it reduced the investor sentiment? So outbreak of COVID, reduction in investor sentiment, people are keeping their money in bank. Which is providing banks with supply of funds, right? So they are getting cheaper rates from RBI as well as the depositors are not withdrawing their money. So that is why they can afford to cut the rates. I hope now we are clear with this, how coronavirus helped RBI to bring down the interest rates. Here you can see some statistics that are going to clear this concept for you. Between January 2019 and February 2020, that is, so we have divided the statistics into two periods, pre-COVID and post-COVID and after the outbreak of COVID. So this is the pre-COVID period where RBI cut the repo rates by 135 basis points, that is about 1.35%, right? So RBI cut its rate by 1.35%, but the rates by which bank cut their lending rate was only 53 basis points, that is 0.53%. So a 1.35 reduction by RBI led to a 0.53% reduction in by banks. Whereas here you can see since February, after the outbreak of COVID, RBI slashed the repo rates by 115 basis points, that is 1.15% to 4%. So we covered this news in when the lending rates came down, if you remember. And as a result of this, the effect that it has produced is a 0.72% reduction in banks' lending rates, as you can see here. So here rate cut is huge, but the effect is less. But here, as you can see, 1.15% reduction by RBI leading to a 0.72% reduction by banks. So you can see better transmission of interest rate cuts, right? So I hope now you understand this point, how after the outbreak of corona, the interest rates by banks, the lending rates by banks have fallen rapidly, right? So I think we can move ahead to the next. Okay, before moving to the next question, I think where we discussed the question previously in one of the sessions about how bringing down policy rates, it reduces the yield on safer investments, right? So guys, most of you had a problem in understanding that how bringing down the policy rates leads to a reduction on this return. So guys, see, when the central bank is cutting down the interest rate, it wants that people should invest into riskier assets so that the economy boosts, economy grows, right? So when RBI, it cuts the policy rates, the return on safer investments which are usually linked to RBI's rates. So let's say there is an investment, a safe investment avenue which provides a return of repo rate plus 3%. So now RBI reduces the repo rate, So this repo rate is going to go down. So obviously the return on this safe investment is also going to go down. So many a times the interest rates of this safe investments is going to come down. So these interest rates are usually linked to RBI's rate, right? The policy rates which RBI decides or determines. So I hope now you are clear with it. Okay. So now moving ahead to the third question for today, which says once a borrower's account is declared fraud, banks need to set aside -% of the outstanding loans as provisions either in one go or over -quarter. So this is a recent news, right? One of the banks has declared one of their accounts as fraud, and now you have to tell what percentage of their outstanding loans to that borrower they have to set aside as provisions and in what time period, right? So the correct option for this question is option A. So this is the correct option. That means the banks have to set aside 100% of the outstanding loans as provisions either in one go or over 4 quarters. So this news relates to PNB declaring DHFL exposure as fraud. So now PNB, Punjab National Bank, has declared that the money that it lent to DHFL, ki Punjab National Bank ne jo bhi money DHFL ko diya, DHFL kya hai? DHFL ek company thi Divan Housing Finance Limited ke naam se, jisme bahut sari financial troubles aa rahi thi. If you remember, it was all over the news, right? So Punjab National Bank ne DHFL ko jitna bhi loan diya hai, now PNB is saying कि वो एक्सपोजर जो है, वो लोन जो है, वो फ्रॉड है, बिकॉज DHFL से हमें कोई पैसा वापस नहीं मिलने की कोई उम्मीद है कि कोई भी पैसा वापस नहीं मिलेगा. सो PNB थिंक्स दैट नो मनी इज गोइंग टू कम बैक फ्रॉम दिस फ्रॉम द लोन्स लेंड टू DHFL, एंड दैट इज व्हाई दे आर फ्रॉड. सो बिकॉज देर वर मेनी रॉन्ग डूइंग्स दैट वर गोइंग ऑन इन DHFL के मैनेजमेंट के साथ भी काफ़ी सारी प्रॉब्लम्स चल रही थी. So that is why they have declared them as fraud. And PNB told that they had a 3688.58 crore exposure to DHFL. So that is about 3700 crore exposure to DHFL. Itne ke loans unhone PNB ne DHFL ko diye hue the. And ab kya hota hai? The law says, laws kya kehte hain ki jab koi bhi bank declare karta hai ki particular account fraud hai, तब उसको उतना ही अमाउंट का प्रोविजन बनाना पड़ता है जितने का उसने उनको लोन दिया है. दैट मीन्स इफ PNB हैज गिवन अबाउट 3700 करोड़ लोन टू DHFL, देन इट वुड हैव टू मेक 100% प्रोविजन ऑन इट, दैट इज ऑफ द सेम अमाउंट. दिस अमाउंट दैट इट कैन डू इन ईदर वन गो, एक बार में बना सकते हैं, वन टाइम में बना सकते हैं, या फिर 4 quarters के दौरान ये काम किया जा सकता है ओवर 4 quarters, राइट? So two options for it, either in one go or over 4 quarters. And why do you think this is necessary? Why do banks need to create such provision? So this is because when they see a failure or they do not receive payments from the accounts which have been declared as fraud, जब उनको इससे कोई भी पैसा नहीं मिलेगा, तब एकदम से उनको बहुत बड़ा झटका ना लग जाए. अगर आपको पता हो, if you know that something bad is going to happen to you in future financially, then you start saving up for it, right? So अगर आपको पता है कि कोई future में problem आने वाली है, तो आप पहले ही उसके लिए save करना या उसके लिए जुगाड़ करना start कर देते हो, right? So same is the case with banks, so that they don't get a big blow when they do not get payments, ताकि उनको एकदम से बड़ा झटका ना लगे. इसलिए laws कहते हैं कि आप पहले ही उतना पैसा जोड़ना शुरू कर दो, right? That is why the law says you have to be prepared for it that can cause any harm to banks. So PNB has already made a provision of about 1250 crores, right? Okay, I think we can move ahead to the next question now. And here is our question number 4 for today, which says select the option which is one of the condition that has to be fulfilled before credit rating agencies can withdraw the rating of a certain instrument. So there are certain conditions that have to be fulfilled when a rating agency withdraws its rating for a certain instrument. जब credit rating agency किसी instrument को, किसी bond को, किसी share को मना कर देती है कि हम इसको rating नहीं देंगे और अपनी ratings को withdraw कर लेती है, उससे पहले कुछ conditions को fulfill करना होता है. So उसमें से एक जो correct condition है वो आपको यहाँ पे दी हुई है and you have to tell which one is that correct condition. So let's now move ahead to the correct option, and the correct option for this question is solution C. Option C is correct, that the CRA here refers to credit rating agency, has rated the instrument continuously for 3 years or 50% of the tenure of the instrument, whichever is higher. So laws क्या कहते हैं कि CRA तभी withdraw कर सकती है अपनी ratings को तभी हटा सकती है, या तो उसने continuously 3 साल उस instrument को rate किया हो या फिर 50% of its life. So कम से कम या तो 3 साल के लिए rate किया हो या फिर 50% of the instrument. So let's say अगर एक company है जिसके instrument को, जिसकी debt को, let's say जिसके bond को issue हुए 10 years हो चुके हैं, तो उस case में कम से कम 5 साल रेट किया हो CRA ने, और अगर ये अमाउंट, ये 50% अमाउंट 3 ईयर से कम आता है तो कम से कम 3 ईयर्स रेट किया होना चाहिए, राइट, विच एवर इज हायर. सो हेयर आर रेस्ट ऑफ द कंडीशंस. सो दिस कंडीशन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. उसके बाद जो क्रेडिट रेटिंग एजेंसी है, इट हैज टू रिसीव अ नो ऑब्जेक्शन सर्टिफिकेट फ्रॉम 75% ऑफ द बॉन्ड होल्डर्स of the outstanding debt and received an undertaking from the issuer that another rating is available on the instrument. So it means that whoever are the investors of this instrument on which CRA wants to withdraw its rating, let's say there is a credit rating agency, so this is a rating agency, and here is a company X Limited which has issued a bond. Now the rating agency wants that whatever rating it has given to this bond, it wants to withdraw it, right? So if it wants to withdraw it, first of all, this is the first condition that we discussed, that either it should have rated it for 3 years or 50% of its life, right? Let's say the life of this bond has been 10 years, that means the rating agency should have rated it for 5 years. After that, whoever holds this bond, so all the investors of the bond, this rating agency would have to get a no objection certificate from 75% of the investors, at least 75% of the investors. So is rating agency ko investors ke paas jana hoga jinhone bhi is bond mein invest kiya hai, aur kam se kam 75% logo se 75% logo se ek certificate lana hoga jisme wo likhe ki unko koi problem nahi hai agar rating agency withdraw kar leta hai, right? So it will have to draw non-objection certificate from at least 75% of the investors, in which they say that they do not have any problem with credit rating agency withdrawing its rating, right? And they have to receive an undertaking from the issuer. Who is the issuer here? The X Limited. They have to receive an undertaking. Is X Limited se bhi unko ek undertaking lena hoga. They have to take an undertaking from it, in which X Limited says that there are other rating agencies who are rating their instrument, right? So that only then this rating agency can withdraw its rating. Or if the issuer has been assigned a default rating, if it is exposed that the issuer is defaulted, then the rating agency can withdraw its rating, right? So I hope the conditions are clear to you, these two conditions or the default rating. So credit rating agencies, very important, their job is very important, because they are the entities who provide information to investors about the instruments they are investing in, that whether they are credit worthy or they are not, or whether they are going to pay back their money or not. Ye jo rating agency hoti hai, inhi ke through investors ko idea lagta hai ki kya unka paisa wapas aayega ya nahi aayega, right? I think we all know about this, that a rating agency is a company that provide different scores to different companies on the basis of their credit worthiness. Rating agency क्या करती है, एक तरीके से marks देती है हर company को उनकी financial performance पे, कि क्या वो investors का पैसा वापस कर पाएंगे या फिर नहीं कर पाएंगे, right? So a very simple question. I think we can move ahead to the last question for today. And here is the last question for today, which says, what rating is assigned to a firm by credit rating agencies if they do not provide sufficient financial information to CRAs. So, if there is a company who does not provide proper financial information to credit rating agencies for their assessment, CRAs have an option of rating them. And you have to tell which is the rating that they give to such companies. Such companies who do not provide information, adequate information. And the correct option for this question is option D. That is non-investment grade with INC rating. So what is the meaning of INC? Issuer not cooperating. Let us discuss about this. Okay. So, first point, we understood that. Okay, let's discuss it from here. That credit rating agencies, so this was recently in news, some credit rating agencies, they asked SEBI and RBI, the regulators, that they wish to stop rating credit instruments and bank loans of uncooperative issuers. So they told the regulators that there are some companies, there are some banks, there are some issuers, there are some entities who have issued the instruments like debt, but the point is they are not providing us with enough financial information. That is why we cannot do a proper judgment on that, on them, or we cannot give a true and adequate assessment, on a transparent assessment on them. It is very difficult to work for us like this. So kuch credit rating agencies ne SEBI aur RBI ko kya bola ki dekho kuch companies aisi hain jo hume properly information nahi de rahi hain, to hum calculate kaise kare ki kya ye acha kar rahi hain ya ye bura kar rahi hain ya fir inko kitna score milna chahiye, kitni rating milni chahiye. So this is one problem that CRAs are facing, and they complained about this to SEBI and RBI, right? Now who are the uncooperative issuers? They are those entities who have issued the debt instruments like bonds. So uncooperative issuers, wo companies, wo entities hoti hain jinhone debt instruments to issue kar rakhe hain, who have issued their debt instruments like bonds. So they have taken debt from the market, they have taken loans from the market, but they are not providing information that how is their financial standing, whether they are doing good, whether they are doing bad, is everything financially sound, or they are facing any financial troubles, right? So they are not providing adequate information. That is why uncooperative issuers they are called as, right? So SEBI is not in favor of this demand. SEBI is not giving in to this demand of credit rating agencies, because SEBI is thinking that rating agencies provide information to investors. If they will not rate such issuers, how is the investor going to know about the financial standing of the company or the issuer, that whether they should hold the debt, they should hold the bonds, or they should sell it, whether they are going to get their money back or not. So SEBI thinks that the work of CRAs is very important from the point of view of investor. That is why they should not withdraw the rating of uncooperative companies. So the problem of CRAs is genuine, that they are unable to perform a fair analysis because they do not have enough information. Unke paas puri information hi nahi hai. To properly analyze kaise karenge, proper analysis nahi kar payenge. So SEBI is understanding this concern, but they are saying it is very important that you rate them, because investor is dependent upon you. Investor aap hi ki taraf dekhta hai, rating agencies ki taraf dekhta hai, jab usse decide karna ho ki mujhe kahan apna paisa dalna hai aur kahan nahi dalna hai, right? So now SEBI has mentioned one more thing, that if this non-cooperation continues for another 6 months, so first of all, for first 6 months, if they do not cooperate, they are going to get a rating of non-investment grade with INC rating. INC, I told you, issuer not cooperating. Taki investors ko pata chal jaye that these issuer is not providing adequate information to CRAs, so that the investors know because of this rating that the issuer is not providing proper information to CRAs, right? And if for another 6 months this wrongdoing carries on, they still do not provide adequate information, no new ratings would be issued to such issuer, unko koi bhi nayi rating nahi di jayegi, ya tab tak jab tak wo ya to proper information de, cooperate kare, unless and until they cooperate, no new rating would be given to them, or they default and the rating is withdrawn by either default or by any other reason, right? So guys, these were the 5 questions for today. I hope you learned something new from this video, and if you did, then don't forget to hit the like button. We'll be back tomorrow with such information for you which can be helpful for you. And thank you for being here. Thank you for giving your time. Till then, take care of yourself and keep your studies going on. And